Howdy y'all, Bearded Carpenter here. I'm milling the logs for the top plates for the cabin at Paradise Point. I have one top plate already milled. We cut these just a few days ago and pulled them out of the woods and got them over here. And I'm gonna show you how I set up my Alaskan mill. Now, I realize there are lots of videos on milling with an Alaskan mill. A lot of them use ladders or whatever, boards, 2x6s, 2x8s, 2x10s for a guide to get the first cut. But I'll show you what I do. Now, this is not an idea that I came up with. This is actually a friend of mine, actually Al, that I've worked with in years past, is the one that showed me this. And I don't know where he got the idea, if he thought it up himself. If he did, it's really genius. But it works really well, especially when you're milling longer logs. These logs are 21 feet. I'll show you what I've got going here. When I put a log up on the sawhorses, I like to turn the crown where it's parallel or out this way, sitting on the horses, peeled off bark where my chain will be going on both sides. This got drugged through some dirt. We had a pretty good chore getting them out of the woods, but we got them over here. Now, the first thing I do, I put a center line here with my level, and then I've measured up and measured down from that center line to get the thickness, which in this case is 6 inches. And actually, I went an eighth more on the going up on this line. There, I got that sticky stuff on me. And I went down 3 1/8. So the total width or thickness of this log will be 6 1/4. Now, you can see this setup here. Now, this kind of looks crude, but it works really well. I just made a flat spot on top there, and I've got this screwed down just with some drywall screws. And this is just made out of OSB. It's beginning to deteriorate a little bit, but I've got some screws in here that holds this. Now, this is what I call my leveling block. This is just a 2x4, and these boxes are just, I think the base is like 5.5 inches, and this piece here and on the other side is 3.5, and I've got some little pieces on the end where I've just nailed it together with a finish gun, and I cut these 2x4 blocks on a little bit of a taper so that I can tilt this thing whichever way I need to without it catching over here or over here. I think it's about maybe a 5-degree angle that I put on them. I can't remember. I've had these for several years. But I level up this with a level, and then I just put a screw in it just to hold it. It's pretty solid there. Now, this is the butt end of the log, the big end. I think it measured like 17 inches. And I've got another, what I like to call these, a leveling block. And I've got my line, my center line, and then the cut line here and here. And I just made another flat spot, and I screwed this down just through the base. And I like to start at the butt end of the log to set this part, because I can sink it down in this box farther, because at the tip it's going to be different. This part will be up out of this box more than it is here. So I drop this down at the butt as far as I need to get it. And then I put my level across here, put my screws in, and screwed it off so it can't move. On my initial setup, with me working from the butt back towards the tip, I just get this level, just whatever it is, I just level it up and screw it off so it can't move. And then I'll measure from here, the top of this, down to this top line here. And in this case, it was 9 inches. Now, I'll go to the tip, and I'll bring this up, the little 2x4, up to 9 inches above this line. And that lets me know that I have the heart of the log, or the pith, will be parallel with the tops of these blocks. Now, I raise this up so that it's 9 inches up from this line, and I put my string on there. I pull it to the other end. I brought it back over here and tied it off. And the string is, you may hear it twinging there. They're pretty tight. And since this log is 21 feet long, I've got two more of these leveling blocks set up here. I've got one here One down there, I measured in 7 feet, and I just cut another little flat spot and screwed this down, and I could bring the block up to the string and put a screw in it. Now, since this log does have a little bit of a crown, this string here didn't ride on top of the 2x4 block, and so I brought this one up to it, and I sided across the top of this just to where I could see the underneath side of the string over here, so it lines up with this string right here. Now this one was in line well enough where I could just bring the block up to the string on both sides and put my screws in so that it doesn't slip down. Now at this point I'm through with the string. I can take it down. I've got my rack up here, just made out of some 2x4s, and I think it's 10 feet long, and I've just got some blocks in between it and got some little blocks in the corner to kind of keep it square. Just a simple thing, just screwed on with Torx screws, and you can see it's been used several times. I've got it screwed with a 2-inch Torx screw to the top of this block to keep from sliding back and forth or wiggling around on me. And I've got it screwed off here to the first leveling block out here in the middle of the log. Now I think this is 3 inches. I actually straight edged these when I got them before I put it together. Well, that shows to be about 3 1/8. I think the end of my tape is worn some. But I'm measuring down to this first line, and I'm measuring about 12 1/8. Now the thickness of my saw curve with my chain is about 3/8 of an inch. So when I set my mill, instead of setting it on 12 1/8, I'll set it on 11 3/4, and that'll take up pretty much for the thickness of the chainsaw cut. I'm not sure how well you can see that, but I like to set my saw up here before I start it and just check after I've got everything set to make sure I'm pretty close to that line. Now, since I have marked these lines out to be a little bit thicker than 6 inches to give me some little room to play with as far as planing and hewing, I'm pretty close to that line. Now when I get to the other end, it may be just a little bit above it or just a little bit below it, but I'll still have the thickness that I need. If you notice, I've got my track extended out past where I'll start, and that gives me a place to rest my saw to get my cut. And when I get to the other block, I'll stop and take my screws out and slide it on down to the next set of blocks, or to the next block down there. And I can keep going and get to the other end. I'll take all of this off and just take these blocks, these leveling blocks out. And then I'll make my second cut, which will be the 6 or 6 1/4 in this instance. Okay, here we go. And it's a good idea to wear some hearing protection. My hearing's not too good anymore from listening to all this stuff, but I do have some earplugs, and that will help to protect my ears from the noise of this.